Managers meeting July 25th, 2013.
Sunshine Law. Notice of this public meeting has been provided to the news media and in a public notice posted at City Hall in the city of Burlington, New Jersey, at the Keegan Recreational Center, 522 Wood Street, Burlington, New Jersey, as required by law. It is also posted at burlingtonislandnj.com. We ask that members of the public, including the Friends of Burlington Island, hold questions and comments until the public portion unless recognized by the chair.
Everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Carlbon?
Here.
Caruso?
Here.
James?
Here.
Nacava is present. Reinhardt?
Here.
Sunstein? Was excused. And Wirth?
Here.
Motion to set adjournment time, please.
Second.
Motion has been made and seconded to adjourn at 9:00. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? 9:00 it is. First on the agenda is the secretary's report. Have all managers had a chance to read the minutes?
Second.
Motion has been made and seconded to accept the June 27th, 2013 minutes. On the question. Does any manager have any questions, corrections, comments?
I just saw them briefly. I'll take it that they're abbreviated minutes. If there were other things said, it was just really just giving me a quote at this point. It's a subject that they're aware. Okay, great. Aye.
Okay, all in favor? Opposed? Minutes are accepted. We will skip on the agenda the treasurer's report because she doesn't get done work till 7:00, so she should be here shortly.
I did hear from her, Mr. Chair. I think she might be a little later because they had an emergency dental procedure that had to happen.
Okay, that's not a problem.
First thing,
we'll go to the website, Manager James.
Okay, going over the website, and it's becoming a problem. And that was noticed when we had a slight problem with the PO box. It mentions in several places our mailbox is 116, it should be 114. Yes. I got a whole list here. It's incredible because I was working with Manager Sunstein to get Chris Wolf to make these changes. Prime example, just to get the new managers posted, it took 2 months. There's links that are not working. You know, currently states the Keegan Center. Yeah, we're meeting on a Wednesday. Now it's Thursday, and we don't meet at the Keegan Center anymore. Yeah. There is one link to a past secretary, Carmela Caruso. How long ago was that? What I'm asking the board is if we can get control of this website. I know Manager Sunstein's not here, but this has been total frustration. Because I can't even get the PayPal link booked into the site. As it stands now, the board does not even have the administrative password to our site. And I've done some looking. We are hosted with GoDaddy, and I believe what I would like to do is have permission from the board start building a new site, just in case we can't get rights from our current website from Chris Wolf.
Well, my suggestion is I think that Mr. Wolf should be contacted and immediately relieved of whatever he's doing, because apparently he's not doing what he was supposed to do, and I know there's not much of a charge, and he's not giving us any bills, but this goes all the way back to when Jim and Mary were both working on the website.
Yeah.
Jim had nothing but problems. I think the guy's pretty much wore out as well. I don't think we need to build a new site. I think we just need to regain control of ours. And we do need somebody that has web experience. Because because I don't have web experience, I'll be honest with you.
The new system is cut, copy, and drop. And I started playing around with it, with the general site today. Not for a board, but I would like to start building the site, just in case he takes our site down.
Well, I don't think he can do that.
No.
That's our site.
He has administrative rights.
I'm not sure about that. That site belongs to the Board of Audit Managers. We paid to have that website created.
We paid for the domain name.
When does Manager Sunstein do that?
North Carolina, I think the week starts on Friday. I think it starts on Friday, so they'll probably know tomorrow.
Now, I think
Saturday, probably.
Probably Saturday. So maybe over the weekend, even Sunday or Monday, contact Mary.
Okay.
And we'll get a handle on it immediately, because this website, since it's been built, has been nothing but trouble, including costing this board $2,000 in money that we didn't have.
If I can, we definitely did pay for the domain names. It was about, I would even say 3 months ago. I know Murray, I believe Murray donated the money to renew the domain names for this year. And, you know, so someone might have administrative rights, but the names, the website still belong to us. We just need the username and password to get in.
And I believe that, I'm not even sure that the username and password was ever changed by Chris. We were having a problem.
It was supposed to be, I can't confirm either.
We couldn't have changes made, and we literally had a problem where somebody went in and did stuff.
I can say that a friend of mine does have some website experience. He had, considered before helping us for free just to change a few things. He's not good enough to build a complete website, you know, that's super complicated, but enough to fix links and change addresses and names, things like that. He's more than capable.
That'd be the first step. I'll contact Mary.
He's on vacation as well, but I'll reach out to him and see if he's still interested in giving us a hand and doing some repairs on that.
But wait until he gets back, honey.
$501(c)(3), $995, and how are you going to be able to do this now, or do you need to wait for the treasurer?
We should have the treasurer here. We have some of the reports and some of the information. So we need to sit down. Because basically from the IRS, I did contact the person that helped this board get it with the IRS. Basically, we only have a few more days because it's basically we have to file 2012 within 5 months, 15 days at the end of the board's fiscal year. And I believe the board's fiscal year is April 1st, the election.
What period of time is that?
5 months, 15 days. So we're getting real close.
And that's for 2012?
For 2012.
There's a partial for 2011?
Yes, it's a short year form for one, the 501(c) was formed to the board's, from that date to the board's fiscal year ending year, that will be a short year form. Since we did not file that, according to the IRS, we have to do the long form. That's the nightmare.
I think I printed that. They gotta be kidding me, that thing's like 20 pages.
And the only thing I am currently waiting on, that is the contact with the state, and hopefully sometime in the next couple of days, the paperwork from the state New Jersey Division of Taxation will get us the forms from there.
So we do have our EIN number, correct?
Yes.
And we do know the proper name that it was registered?
Yes.
You have a copy of the EIN, right? I gave that to you last meeting?
It's somewhere.
All right, I know I gave it to Darlene. If you need it again, let me know.
Okay.
All right, so now between myself, yourself, and the treasurer.
When it goes through,
once we have the information, we'll go to town.
Yeah.
And file whatever.
Now, we only got a few more days left.
There's state and federal?
Yes.
All
Mr. President, I actually went to Darlene's house today because she was not, she's been working overtime a lot lately. And I did get what paperwork she was given. Mostly it's bank statements, very little correspondence, none from the state that I could find. So the question is then, was there any correspondence for taxation up to date? And if so, who has it?
No, they don't correspond with you. It's your own responsibility to file.
Well, when we were given that designation though, is there something, could it possibly be that the historian or somebody has it when we were given the 501c?
Okay, normally, the IRS says, sends you a booklet, a 30-page booklet. It starts with a 501A and works your debt down, which you are supposed to do, and it tells you what you're responsible for, and it breaks it down even further, what kind of contributions are acceptable and non-acceptable under their terms. It's a 36-page booklet.
If I can, the booklet we received from the IRS wasn't that big. It was more of like a small leaflet. It was a pamphlet. They never sent us anything bigger than that because I know for a few meetings we had a bunch.
Maybe like this, huh?
Yeah, but it was no bigger than that. Because I know even after receiving the booklet, a few of us had questions about what donations were eligible, et cetera, and that information was not in that booklet. I believe it would be in what's called the President's Box because I did turn it over before I left for Spain last summer because I didn't want to have anything important that the board may need while it's gone.
And I did search through that box and it's not.
No.
Okay, what I'll do is an internet search through the IRS.gov and see if I can get a PDF and have it printed out.
Yeah, just give me a PDF file and I'll download it and print it. Okay, so there are two things that are of equal importance, both the website and the 501c3 file. That's something that has to be handled before the next meeting. Correspondence. I received through the mail the Burlington City High School commencement program from 2013. And I have three thank you cards for these scholarships. I will start with the first one, which was a scholarship. Yeah, I know. And I gave Jamie the opportunity. She said, was a scholarship in memory of Stella Atala provided by Mike and Jamie Zaylot. To Mr. Zaylot and Miss Zaylot, I would like to thank you both for awarding me the Stella Atala Memorial Scholarship. It was a great surprise to hear my name called for it on my graduation day, and I immensely appreciate it. With much appreciation, Rosemary Reed. The second one was the Board of Item Manager Stella Atala Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $150. That went to Andrew Jones. Dear Board of Item Managers, thank you for your generous award that I received at graduation. I greatly appreciate your kindness. I'm looking forward to the future with great enthusiasm. Thank you again. Sincerely, Andrew Jones. That was the $150 Stella Atala from the board. And third was a $600 scholarship from the Board of Item Managers. Dear Board of Item Managers, thank you very much for your generous scholarship. Since freshman year, musical theater has been a passion of mine. I am planning to attend Camden County College to pursue a career in musical theater. This scholarship will most definitely help me attain my goal. Thank you again, sincerely, Cassandra Renshaw. So they were the three recipients, and all have sent thank you cards. If anybody would like to see the commencement exercise book with the names printed in it, I have a copy.
I would like to see that.
Second. The second piece of correspondence was from the Courier Times, which is, I guess, the County Times. And I believe this is for the ad to change the meeting date that we postponed, and I believe this is paid, so I'm gonna hold this for the treasurer. I do believe this was paid. Manager Caruso Naprava needed the meeting postponed, and she did pay for this ad out of her own pocket, so I believe that the they
didn't pay it direct, gave the money to the board.
I gave the treasurer $30 this meeting.
So I'll set that aside. If she hasn't paid it, we'll make sure it was paid. Third, I received bill from Holston, McDonald used to visit Ziegler and Lodge. I will make copies of it. There are three charges. One is from March 18th, one is from March 19th, one is from June 10th, and the total is $76.50. For whatever reason, the post office box didn't get paid for on time. They locked us out of it. Mary has since went and paid the first 6 months out of his own pocket. I'm going to donate the second 6 months. I have two keys to the post office box. They're new keys. They changed the lock. So I will be giving one key to the secretary and I'll have the other. So we should have had two keys to the old box because they issued two keys. However, since I've been here, there's only been one key. We're still PO Box 114. Everything stayed the same other than the mail. They weren't putting the mail in it, so it was late getting the mail. So I will make a copy of this bill and make sure all the managers have it for the review. So we will put this aside and we won't worry about paying this at the present time. Public portion. Any member of the public wishing to speak, please step to the microphone, state your name and address. Any member of the public? Yeah, they're a little touchy.
Joe Abate, 192 Glenwood Avenue in Burlington. And the reason I'm here tonight is I guess the post office box didn't get paid and then it got changed?
No, it didn't get paid, so I went in to get the mail and I seen a wire through the lock where you stick the key. So I contacted Murray, he went down, cut him a check. In the meantime, they had changed the locks, the key cylinder.
But I, as you know, through the many years that I served on this board, I remember it as 114.
Correct.
When I went onto the web page, it's 116.
Did you get here late?
Yeah.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, okay, you didn't hear us talking about that. It was a mistake on the website.
Oh, I didn't.
How that got to be 116 on the website. Well, did you mail that to 116?
I mailed it to 114, and you guys never got it. It was returned. And basically what that is, Mr. President, is you can open it. Yeah, it's my resignation as the, I guess, person in charge of community service. And there were four books that I had one of them open, as a matter of fact. Excuse me one second.
Joe, do you remember the date you mailed this? Because the postmark is July 20th.
The letter. The letter.
Okay.
The community service program, the individual that was working finished her hours. And what she did was to copy a lot of the board's records onto a flash drive. And we copied that as well. So I have the four books because I gave President Caruso the key, so I couldn't get back in to put these back in there. And I have a letter stating these are the four books to be signed that I gave them back to him. And you should just be aware of the unbelievable assets to the present administration that these, that this information is. For instance, a letter to the chairman of the county school board, which was the board at the time. I understand that a portion of the entire Burlington Island is for sale. If so, will you kindly furnish me, this writer, with a plan of property and complete detail list from a company in Philadelphia, September 21st, 1929. And here's another letter in August to the mayor indicating some interest, a company called Harry Strathman Sand and Gravel from Paulsboro.
Let me just share these with you. But more importantly, in the little bit of time that I did have to read from this, I discovered some very interesting things that the board should be aware of. One is that in May the 6th of 68, the matter of installing some 40 telegraph poles on Burlington Island to afford electric service to the campers was thoroughly discussed, and on a motion by Mr. Stettler and second by Dr. Fagan, it was decided that no pole concept or easement was given at this time in view of our Green Acres concept of the island and the loss of trees that would be involved. The secretary was instructed to write public service and so indicate, as well as to advise, that we would entertain a proposal for entertaining for underground wiring at no expense to the island board and without any responsibility to the board. Signed, respectfully, A. Walter Zimmerman, secretary. So there is a wealth of information, and it shows, geez, what, 40 years ago, the board was into Green Acres. And then also in here was mention of income to the board from the water board of the city of Burlington. It was also mentioned in the minutes that at the end of the time where the city doesn't use these wells, that it becomes the property of the island managers. So in here, and in Canindy's disc, there's a lot of good stuff. So I would just amplify the fact that the community service project makes this more accessible, and we all know knowledge is power. And there's a lot of knowledge on these discs that we have right here, and there's copies. So if you lose one, you got the other. Wouldn't be a bad idea to make another copy too. And Nick, if you'd be so kind, just to take a look at what I'm asking you to sign that you received.
Yeah, they're two of the same exact last row.
They should be,
same,
yes.
Same.
Could be a backup. But really good to have them in today's times. There's drawers of information on here. So I'm just asking you to sign if you've seen, you know, these books. And I would hope that someone on the board steps forward and continues with the community service program. We've done a lot of good things. The board has gotten thousands of dollars in wood from docks that unfortunately are still out there in the field, needing somebody to finish up on that. And I also, you should know, sent my letter of resignation to Wendy Young at the probation department for Burlington County, and advised her to contact the president of the board. So if you'll be so kind to sign that I received.
I did.
That you did.
You're ready to go.
That would be good. Thank you very much.
All right. On behalf of the board, I would just like to once again thank Joe. He did invest a lot of his own personal time with the community program, and at the present time, there's no one on this board willing to invest that kind of time. I'm not saying that won't change, but it is a lot of time, and it's a lot of personal time at strange hours. And Joe was willing to take that on, and he'd done an excellent job with not only that project, it was more than just the minutes. It was the docks, a couple of times on the docks, correct, Joe?
Yes.
At least a couple of times.
Yes.
Once again, on behalf of the board, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Any other member of the public? Any other member of the public wishing to speak? Seeing none, I will close the public portion. Old business.
Before you go through, if anyone would like to just take a quick look, I put the flash drive in and you can see the files. I just pulled up one as an example, but it looks like they range between. It looks like they begin in 1929, skipped years here and there, where I guess there wasn't any records or they're still in the filing cabinet, and it goes up to 1994. Then there's also a folder for 2005. It has elections 1979, with most of them until 1995.
Just one question I did have, Joe.
Very thorough.
Is there a way of having her name so we can draw a thank you letter and send it to her, because this community service has confidential information? I know she came here once and met us.
Oh, well, I think a thank you letter is certainly appropriate, and I will, because she did a great job. I will get you that information.
Okay, thank you.
I'll get that for you.
Mike?
With the work that Joe presented you and the work that I've done on the previous, we have from 1852 to 1994 minus a 20-year period. And that should be almost a complete history of the board for that time.
Minus which 20-year period?
Between 1909 and 1929. That wasn't in my files when I had done the original, and I guess it wasn't in Joe's.
1909 to 1929.
That's that missing book.
What's that?
That's the missing book.
Now, what years did yours start, Mike?
1852, and it went to 1909.
And Joe took us from 1929 to
1994.
1994. And then 2005 was also in there, but the years between. There's a few years missing here and there, but.
Probably because there's not books.
Yeah.
There may be on that other disc as well.
I have them both in.
They're both have both flash drives in one.
Yeah, but you gave us a flash drive prior. You gave us a flash. I have a flash drive in the president's box.
Okay.
Would I be able to get that so I could make an additional copy?
Yes, I'm going to give you the whole box and a key to the filing cabinet. But you did give us a flash. The first time she was here, she gave us a flash drive.
Okay, good. See?
So that all definitely has whatever is not on here.
There's more in the file than done. There's more files that we didn't get to. I don't know what's in them, but it would be good to be able to capture those files in a digital form, just in case something were to happen. I know it's a fireproof cabinet, and they're pretty safe, but more importantly, it gives you access to this information.
Easy access. You don't have to grab a book. You grab a flash drive and plug it in.
Hey, that stuff is better reading than most newspapers these days. I mean, it's amazing the things that were in there. Sorry, I get confused.
That's okay.
Well, they practically give flash drives away during the back-to-school sales. I'll see if I can grab a few, and I'll make additional backups for the board. And I think it would be a good idea to perhaps keep them in two separate places.
Very good.
Mr. President, I remember the conversation now that you mentioned it with John Alexander. There may be more files stashed away in Burlington's files of the Island Board, so if somebody could contact them, that would give them better history.
Burlington City's files.
Burlington City's files. And there's an 1825 book that's missing that we look for.
Thank you, Mike.
You're welcome.
Old business.
Old business.
Manager James.
The square up card reader count set up. The current account email password manager Sunstein has it. I know it was changed from when I was originally set up, so only the board officer will have it, and when Mr. Sunstein returns, the treasurer will have it. The PayPal is partially set up. We can't do anything on the website right now, but it can't be posted. Also, to make note, there is a donation of $10 from Square Up to a nonprofit. That's in the general fund account.
I went into her account already?
Yes.
Now, is the treasurer aware of that? Or will she say the book's not balancing?
I wish she was here.
Well, she will be here.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So Square Up?
The card reader is active, that account is active. It's tied into our general account.
And Mary, at this point, has...
Has the email and the password.
Which will be passed on also to the treasurer?
Yes.
Now, what are the differences between Square Up and PayPal?
Okay, PayPal, you have your internet, your website, it's functioning, it's working right. There'll be a donation link through PayPal. Anybody around the world can make a donation to, if we can get better control of this website, we can have it into educational specific categories or into a general fund or into a specific cause of the board through PayPal, credit cards. They do it online. Now we have a wine and cheese benefit. We get to have a contributor, we can switch our credit card. We're straight fair. They want to make a credit card contribution or debit card contribution, swipe it within 24 hours, minus 2.76%, it's in our account 24 hours. We'll plug it into a smartphone, a tablet, or a drawer, a card, phone.
Oh, so we have one. Are we getting one of those?
Yeah, you have one. Murray Sunstein has it.
It plugs it in.
Yeah, I
can. Goes right in.
Yeah.
The big thing is the website. That's the key.
Yes.
And it's a shame because that website was supposed to be a tool for this board.
And it can be.
It really hasn't been since Chris Core stopped taking care of it. It's been nothing but a nightmare, so... We will have to address that, and that definitely needs to be addressed immediately, so.
Okay, going back on old business again. Any word on moving the docks? Nick?
Any word on the
ground pounders?
Where do we want to move the docks?
Well, they're no longer, that property was sold.
The property that the docks are sitting on?
Yes, was sold.
So now we're looking for a place to store.
Yeah.
How many docks need to be stored? Wait a minute, let me get a little
docks.
Nine docks. And they are width by length.
Three by 24.
Three wide, 24 long. Okay. They could be stacked, I'm sure. Could they be stacked one on top of the other?
Yeah, but I...
You wouldn't go more than three high, maybe?
Yeah, only for safety reasons.
Okay.
And only two of them are completely finished.
Two are complete.
The other ones, we need a car to finish them up. We have all the lumber there.
So we have the lumber?
Yeah, all the lumber's there.
So seven need to be completed. Now, I believe there's still a hitch or something that has to be done, or hinge?
We have the hinges manufactured. We have all the hinges done.
So you have everything. It's just somebody needs to put them together. Do we have the hardware?
Hardware is easy to come by.
Okay. So what we're actually looking for, and that, the seven that aren't complete, can they still be moved?
Yep.
Are they stripped already? The wood stripped off or no, or just pretty much?
They were stripped and then community service started to stumble at least five. And in the process of getting the board screwed down and getting them not screwed down and leaving them out in the weather, now the boards are starting to work. They can't be left like that. That's the only thing I can say. You know?
The one thing with treated lumber, we could soak it. Yeah. And then it'll straighten out. That is the only good thing if you drench it. All right, let me try to make arrangements. I do have somebody I can talk to that has a place right down there, a fence yard. I don't know whether he has room. If he has room, I'm sure we can store it there. So I got a note here to call him.
The ideal thing would be able to store them at a spot where
if we do get a community service guy, he'll go get a new board. But that's why originally we were thinking about moving them all to the island, but then it creates a problem, we ain't gonna get the guy back. And right away, that, you know, the transportation back and forth to the island has always been our problem.
But if it's a matter of just screwing the boards down, we could do that.
Well, that's what I thought too. Me and Joe spent a day over there, and we looked like a couple morons over there, even though I have quite a bit of mechanical ability. The guy who was doing it, and it was working, and we tried to do it.
And I built a 12x26 deck on my house.
Well, the thing with this is that all the boards are being secured with quarter inch, or maybe 3/16 drive of self-tapping screws in 8-inch steel. So if you don't have the tools and equipment, the air compressor, all the stuff to run the stuff, you're not going nowhere, unless you got some heavy equipment, that's what it is, heavy equipment. He had the proper equipment, he was working it right out of the back of his truck, and he was going smooth until, I think what broke his back was the guy ended up in a divorce.
Yeah.
That did it.
All right. Continue now. Do you have any other old business?
Yes. We're still currently having a problem with the helicopter buzzing the island and the eagles. I've done a lot of tracking down because I caught a good buzz on the lake, on the island, morning of July 5th. And the track of it is coming out of Croydon Sterling Helicopter Service. And this morning, they had 5 birds over that island, helicopters.
And the eagles fledged?
Oh, yeah.
They're fledged.
Okay.
But my suggestion is, I do have the their general manager, their safety officer email address, and I have both their repair facility in Croydon's address and their repair facility in Croydon's, Philly and Croydon's address. We only have a partial, but since it's a repair service, for so many different pieces in and out of there.
It doesn't matter. They
doesn't
know.
Matter. Matter.
They know they're coming out of there. The only thing that we can do
is send a letter.
I'm not even sure sending a letter to them. I would. The way I view it is to contact Fish and Game, because
we've got the letter to.
It is a Fish and Game.
So 2 letters, 1 in each.
Yeah. Or maybe send it to Fish and Game and CC them.
Yeah.
Because I don't know how you would stop them unless they make a no-fly zone over the island. I mean, I don't know who has the power to do that.
You said at least this way, it'll put it on record that they've been notified and those people have dropped.
And if we do have a problem, then, I mean, the conservation officer can move around. I don't know what kind of power they would have in another state, but, I mean, we could draft up a letter to go to Fish and Game.
Wait a minute, Fish and Game is getting a copy of the letter to the FAA.
Yeah, but I mean, it doesn't hurt to follow it up now that we know who it is.
In fact, I could get another copy of that letter and attach it to another letter to Fish and Game.
To Fish and Game, because I think at the time the first letter went out that they got CC'd, we weren't aware of who it was. Now has the information on where them, and it's not too hard to prove. All they got to do is take a ride over. I mean, it's not really that.
It's a very active repair center.
Now, give me that information and we'll put together a letter.
Well, I'll do my homework.
Don't give me your only one. Do you have it?
It's easy to get it off the internet. I'll translate it later.
Yeah. Okay, he's going to translate it for me. Any other old business? Manager Caruso, no problem.
I heard back from one of the Board of Education members today, Jen Montone, and she gave me about 6 or 7 contacts for the lower grade schools and the high school, so I can get in contact with the different schools for what supplies they need. Elms has already offered to put a flyer in their business and to put a box to accept the backpack donations. And I still have to reach out to some more businesses. I was waiting to hear back to get some contacts first so I can get lists of what we need. And UMS has also offered to have a fundraiser for us. I've seen them before. I believe they do like an ice cream pie. And people that buy them, if they mention that, you know, the board's name, they about a 10 or 20% donation goes to the board. So I have to get in touch with her so we could pick a time and date for that.
When you say her?
No, Natalie Barwood at UMS. Yeah, I spoke to her. She said they'd be happy to do a fundraiser for us and also put a large box in the store to accept donations for the backpack drive. So now that I have the contacts at the schools, I'm hoping to get a list this week of the most needed supplies and then reach out to more of the local businesses.
Okay, that is part of the committee, so as long as you keep everyone posted, that's all we're looking for. No major decisions without board approval, but anything, just keep everybody in the loop. The other old business manager, Ryan, what?
Yeah, I just want to put this on the record so that the public knows that this piece of paper was given to every board member that's up here. If there's somebody questioning.
This is what you gave us before we started?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is some of the questions that I've heard over the past month of concerned citizens and people on the island and stuff like that. And I think some of this stuff has already been gone over, but I want to at least put it to the record that it's been stated. Number one was the retreat legal. We'll have to find out about that one way or the other. Number two, if it was legal, how about having one each month with the public, like a town meeting? Number three, public would like a fair chance to chat with the board as in a conversation. Number four, board web page has 1 out of 7 members' phone numbers. Where are the others? Number five, wrong P.O. box on the web page. Is it 114 or 116?
It's 114.
Number six, copyrights on web pages, did the board pay for them and how? Number seven, election page says you must be a registered voter, but it does not mention that you must be a city resident. Number eight, how come we are not listed on the city web page but others are? Number nine, some of our web pages look very broken and unprofessional. Number 10, July the 16th, what was the state marine police up to on the island, and where on the island did they go, and does anybody know about it? Number 11, how about introducing appointment powers to managers if someone leaves the board? Number 12, you have my idea for the island, PIG. Where is anyone else's idea for the island? Thank you.
Some of them we could address. Board webpage. Which one person out of the 7 members has their phone number missing? Does anybody know?
Yes, it's only currently right now, I believe it's only the treasurer.
New treasurer?
Yeah.
So he started working on that because a few months ago
that's where it went.
A bunch of there were everybody's phone numbers met on there.
That's about far as it went.
I'm gonna take a look on there now. I don't have the city's Wi-Fi to get on my computer, but I'll go on my phone.
The wrong PO box, and that's probably been like that. Unless he's made changes and he's saddled up.
Yeah,
so that's 4 and 5. 6 copyrights on the webpage, yes, we did pay for them. So that we do have the copyrights for that webpage. That rolls in the Board of Island Managers. It always has since Chris Corder created it. That's a good point on the election page. It should specify that you must be a city resident. So that's something that has to be corrected.
Okay, real fast, I have a copy of the board directory here. Yeah, there's actually only two phone numbers on there, mine and Darlene Kelly. It does have the current members, it has you listed as president.
So the members are current?
Murray is vice president, yeah, the members are current. And it lists their, the expiration of their term as well.
But only your and Murray's phone number?
No, mine and Darlene Kelly's phone number is on there.
Does it also list you as secretary or just a board man?
Manager and board secretary, yes.
But somewhere else it lists Domenica as secretary?
Yes.
I don't know where else, I'm looking.
You have to go to the link FAQ, click on that.
Okay.
You have to click through a couple of pages. And there's a contact us. It's real hard to do it from a phone.
Well, there's also a link for contact us.
No, one of them was fixed. One email at one time was going to Jim Cipriano. Chris Wolf did fix it. Now it goes to Nick Russo.
It should be going to the board's email. I don't know why it doesn't. But as we said earlier, we need to get this fixed. If there's this many errors, there shouldn't be any.
We're gonna have to sit down.
We're gonna have to sit down.
And go through this website page by page. As painstaking as it may be or may not be, it has to be done.
Can I make a suggestion? Can we make this a workshop?
We can do a workshop. We just have to advertise it. An agenda and advertisement and cover the areas. So I'm going to put something together here on the things that have to be addressed.
Okay, if you do go to FAQ, frequently asked questions, under the question, can I vote for members or even get a seat to be on the board of island managers? At the bottom of that one, under the answer to that question, contact the board secretary or the president. Board secretary is highlighted. When you click on that, it prompts you to send a message.
All right.
To a...
Apparently, he's not qualified to do what he says he can do, or he would have handled it. If people in the public can find it, then a webmaster should be able to find it and correct it, and it's not being done. So. We're going to have to do something as far as a workshop on that to address it. How come we are not listed on the city webpage, but others are? I think at one time we were linked to it. But I think they refused to make changes unless we paid for it.
Yeah.
So we asked to be removed, and it probably took, I don't know, Jeb, 2 years, 3 years to have us. They wouldn't even remove us from their link.
They wouldn't make any changes.
They said if you want change, you know, our officers change every year, or members can possibly change every year. The city would not make any changes, and I'm sure it took at least 2 years at our various requests. I can't even tell you how many letters, and they finally removed us from their link. That's why we're not on there.
What I would recommend is that the board set up an excellent web page that just blows the city's web page out the
door. Yeah.
Well, that wouldn't be too hard to do because that's a lot.
You know, it's time for the board to stand on its own 2 feet linked. And you know, as much as we appreciate City Hall and stuff like that, they're not standing up for us and helping us.
Well, I was actually on their website today. I was looking for a set of minutes from a council meeting. And they have the link set up, but when you go to click to get the PDFs, none of them works. So I don't necessarily think it's not a bad thing though. We're not on there anymore.
The broken web pages, Don's correct on that. Everybody that's talked about it has been on the social network. I haven't went on and looked at it, but it is a disaster. So that has to be addressed. July 16th. When Hal first called me about Marine Police helicopter flying around. I texted my brother, who's a lieutenant with the Burlington City Police Force, and he said they were training. They need to log a certain amount of hours in training. He said they flew up and down the Assiniboine Creek, I guess as far as the creek goes, past Scalzi's Bridge. They flew up and down the river, and they flew around the island. As far as boots on the ground, I don't know that they were physically on the island. That part I don't know.
Yes.
And if they were, they were training. And I'm not sure that anybody on this board or the Burlington City Administration or anybody else could probably stop them from going over there if they're doing the training exercise. I don't think the mayor's executive order is going to scratch the surface. If the state police go onto the island and do a training exercise, I can find out if they actually went on land. I mean, I can find that out. But to the best of my knowledge, they were doing training, helicopter training. They got to log so many hours in training with the helicopter. So they flew, and I mean, I seen it on Facebook 2 minutes after. They were flying. Everybody wanted to know why the state police were flying around the island. So, I mean, if the board wishes, I could find out if they actually were on the island and why, which is, if they were there, they probably were trained. How about introducing appointment powers? That was something that Ron talked about in the past. I've always been against it, even when I was part of the so-called majority. I believe that the people should vote for board members, and that any faction of the board shouldn't have the power to appoint. I don't like appointment powers. I'm in an Italian club, and I don't like appointment powers in that club, and I don't really like it here.
Not that I would introduce with a, unfortunately, you know, let's just sadly say if somebody passed away on the board or somebody right. got sick and had to leave the board or whatever, instead of leaving the board with an empty spot, I would think it would be a fair thing, and it wouldn't be personal in any way then, if whoever got the most votes at the last election could be notified and say, well, you'd like to fill this space that's not available till that election terms up again, you know, one of those kind of things. In other words, that way nobody on the board gets even a chance to choose, you know, one of those kind of things. In other words, it would be it had been an election vote in the first place. You know, that's just my thought, you know what I mean? Right. That way the board wouldn't have a vacant spot.
I mean, it's something we can always discuss. Like I said, I was never for appointment powers when I was part of the minority and part of the majority.
Well, this way nobody appoints anybody.
Yeah.
Public already chose somebody, but they lost at the election.
Right.
You know what I mean? It just sounds fair.
That's something we can discuss further.
See if it's legal, too. Because it's not a bad idea.
Well, I don't know if we have the ability. I think, we have to go by, I don't know if it's the rules and regulations, Mike or Joe might know, about going with the rules and regulations on that to have to do with the Board of Elections. I mean, not the
school board,
but for the school board, yeah, whatever. I don't know what they do. Yeah,
they appoint.
Do they?
The school board appoints. You put an application in, I think. Because right. I believe that they got a vacancy right now. Right. I believe somebody resigned or couldn't finish their term. I don't know who it is, but I'm pretty sure. They have a vacancy and they're accepting what they call an application for the position.
Letter of interest.
Letter of interest.
Yeah. Yeah, I did see that not too long ago.
Public would like a fair chance to chat with the board as in a conversation. Well, they have that in the public portion. I don't know how far we could actually go with it as a board, because we're an elected board. That would be a legal question. I don't know if the board could have a round table with the public. I'm not sure how that, you know, that would be something that...
Well, the reason I brought that up was tying it into if the retreat was in a legal situation, then have the ability to have, like the governor has, like a town meeting. If we had a town meeting, like over at the Keegan, like we used to, it was for a workshop. Well, that was good to bounce things off the walls, come up with ideas, the public could get involved in it, you know, and stuff like that. It was more of a casual atmosphere.
I think we could still have a town hall meeting, a meeting like that, as long as it was advertised. You know what I mean? As long as it was advertised strictly for that purpose. But that's something I can ask Ron. I can ask him that. As far as your first one was a retreat legal, I did ask Ron that, and he didn't know the answer to it. He said he didn't, he couldn't say that it was, and he couldn't say that it wasn't. I know Al sent me a bunch of links where school boards do it all the time. Unfortunately, every link I clicked on said page not found. So I don't know why that did that.
One thing about the retreat that we had was that no Island Board business was discussed at this retreat. The sole purpose of this retreat was to basically help us all to get together to figure out how we can be best organized. You know, people keep talking about a sustainability plan, for example. And the whole purpose of this is to help us work out how we're going to be organized in getting from step A to step D, for example. So it was not, there was no island business discussed. It was just a procedural thing. Would you gentlemen, if you're going to talk, would you please go outside and do it? Thank you. So that's why I think it's legal, because there was no island business discussed. It was strictly how we're going to go about doing all of this stuff. And setting up a procedure, a logical progression, you know, from the beginning to the end.
I've served on a lot of boards for the state in the past, and one is actually a 501c3 now, and there is absolutely no question that it's perfectly legal to have a retreat to discuss mission, to discuss priorities, to unite those priorities. In fact, I have one board meeting coming up, which is, it's a retreat, and it's for directors of art organizations all over the state. And what happens is, for that body, is that they will meet and discuss basically what they think their priorities are for the next year. There's no business decisions made. It's like, what are we going to address and how are we going to address it? What's interesting about that board is they're so far advanced technologically that they actually sent out a survey to all the members with questions, but they were also they also have a great deal of funding behind them in the millions. Again, it's something, you know, in the arts world that we should probably start thinking about here. And I'm glad, by the way, Al, that's great that you're getting that online stuff done for fundraising. Because I get a lot of people from out of town. I know Barbara Fisher gets a lot of people from out of town. Of course, Lillian does. I mean, a lot of people, hundreds, that if you had something like a Starbucks often has, oh, will you give $5 to, you know, to this cause or that cause, you know, it adds up pretty fast. And, you know, I do have a Visa machine at the antiques market. You know, how great would that be if I also had one for the Burlington, for the Island Managers, and for, you know, we could have two accounts someday, you know, for the reach, for the scholarships and for the maintenance and stuff that Don does, and trails, and perhaps someday campsite. But that being said, anyway, I don't know. I know Ron's more a land use attorney, but I would think that there would be no retreats on the other boards I've served on. And certainly, you know, if it was not legal.
What separates us from them, though, is we're elected public officials. That's the difference. So that changes everything. We're elected by the people, and we're public officials. We're just not a board. An art board, or, you know what I mean?
Congress has different.
Well, I mean, we can find out one way or the other before we hold another one, just to be safe.
The question came up, because that throws into the question, well, what's a quorum then? You know, because I was always taught, you know, from sitting in the audience, listening to what came across the board for 6 years. Well, if you have more, if you have four board members sitting down at the same table, well, now you're going to have to publish it in the newspaper for some reason. And I thought that was the stupidest thing that there ever was.
Yeah, because we always broke bread at the Dolphin Diner.
You go down to the diner and get a cup of coffee, and you got four people sitting there. What's that mean? doesn't make sense.
No, it doesn't, because people.
That's why we're so careful not to talk anything island business while we're, you know, but yeah, I agree with you, Don.
And just the very latest one is Don's idea for the island, big. And where's anyone else's idea for the island? That was part of the stuff. That was the very beginning process and why we were working on a retreat to try and find a vision of what we wanted to do. So they're all good points. I mean, and some of them I can research. Some of them we answered. The website being the biggest thing, and that really is. It's pretty hard for me to get embarrassed, and I'm almost embarrassed that website is.
And this has been going on for what, as many years as I can remember dealing with this board.
This website.
Web page has been a problem.
Jim Hill's the website.
Website,
10 years?
We got that when we got the money from the state grant.
It's got to be close to 10.
04?
Right.
04?
Well, this is 13.
Yeah.
It was when Jim Bazoon ran for council, so it's probably been 10 years. That's how we met them guys. When Jim was running for a council seat.
Yes.
So it's been probably 10 years, and it was briefly, Chris Corder set it up. He offered us a plan as far as maintenance and upkeep. The board didn't want to spend the money on it. We kind of left it the way it was. It was good the way it was because we didn't need any changes. But once we started to need changes, it's been this person will do it, that person will do it, and it just deteriorated from that point. So, you know, its value is really now at a minimum, if there's any value at all. I think it's more harmful than anything else at this point.
The value can be turned around really.
Oh, that's not a doubt about that. There's no doubt about that the value can be turned around. It just has to be done. So we're going to have to get together on that. Is there any other old business?
Yes. I'd like to make a motion because this has been lagging on for a couple of months now. There was an offer from Aaron to be the grant writer. I'd like to make a motion to this board to accept Aaron and her services as a grant writer. No, it got tabled.
No, it just was discussed, period.
I'd like to second that.
It's in the minutes.
We have a second?
Who made the second? Scott made the second. Okay, there's a motion and a second on the floor to accept the offer of Aaron McCord to be the board's grant writer. On the question. Any managers have any questions or comments? Can I have a roll call, please?
Carlbaum.
Yes.
Russo.
Yes.
Gaines.
Yes.
Naprava, yes. Reinhardt.
Yes.
Sunstein, not present. Worth.
Yes.
Okay, the motion.
Yeah.
Passes unanimously, and welcome aboard, Aaron. Thank you very much, and we will be in touch. We're working. We're going to be doing many things in a short period of time, hopefully. Any other old business?
Yes, what are we going to do about Wood Street Fair? This has been lagging on for a couple of months now.
Wood Street Fair is September.
Does this board agree to set a general operating guideline for any volunteers to be talked about, and also a general guideline about any, when the managers are attending this event, what we talk about? And it's been lagging for a couple of months now.
Is it the second Saturday in September? It should be September 14th. Is it? It's normally the second Saturday, correct?
Labor Day is the second Saturday.
Is Labor Day late this year on the 9th?
Nah, it can't be the 9th. No more than the 7th.
First Monday is the 2nd. So it's always the weekend after Labor Day?
No. No.
I always thought it was the second Saturday.
It's the second Saturday.
It's the second Saturday, so it would be the 14th. And we haven't received anything from whoever puts that together as far as whether we want to take it.
That'll be Colonial Burlington. I can if the board's permission, I can contact that person if we want to do something. And have my, three managers actually attend. And it would be nice to know now and get our schedule together so we can be present, not last minute.
Okay, real fast, which street fair is Saturday, September 7th?
So it's the first Saturday this year.
2013, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Rain date is September 8th.
Which is a Sunday.
And if you go on whichstreetfair.com, it looks like new applications have been posted for 2013. They have the contact number if we need it.
Hal, you want to jump in on contact number?
I know you're on a personal name, Wilson.
Yeah, and actually there is a nonprofit application on their website. And it gives the details on who needs to be contacted and what needs to be done. And the cost is $35.
Which is worth not a problem.
Nonprofit.
I don't think we paid in the past.
Under nonprofit contract, it says the cost is $35.
Do you remember if we paid in the past? I always thought our fee was waived because we didn't sell anything.
Right.
So that's just $35.
We'll find out.
Hal will find out. What's the board's pleasure? We've done it for at least 10 years.
I'll be finding out this week whether I have the classes on Saturdays. And I can let you know by the end of the week. I'm not sure yet whether I'll have a class on Saturday or not.
Now, the other question is what we're going to do. What are we going to talk about?
Normally we got the same thing every year. I mean, is it when it started out, it was more of a meet and greet. I know when Joe and I done the first few, and Mike, it was more of a meet and greet and just ask people to express what they wanted to say. And then I guess it progressed a little.
We could probably do the same thing. That's what we're going to watch.
The thing is, we have to have updated information because the flyers are outdated. Don?
I have a question on that. I can usually get donate a flat screen and like I did before and use the disc that I use for all the pictures on the island. That seems to work well. I did find a box of old board flyers. Must be 300 or 400 of them in the box.
The brochures?
Yeah, the brochures. I didn't find a box. But it needs on the back, it needs a label placed over the dates and stuff.
We had talked about that, I believe, at the April meeting, yeah.
That's a big label, that's the only problem.
But if we could stick a label over that, then we wouldn't have to print anything. I would just go, just stick a label on it, right. That would be nice.
Right, but the current managers and treasurer.
I found that that's booklet is the most, is probably the most accurate and excellent booklet that I've ever come across.
And we do have quite a few of those.
Yes. Yeah, we have, like I say, I think there's got to be a minimum of 100 of them. I did find a case of them. And the other thing I want to question is that over the 5 years that I've been getting involved in the Wood Street Fair, we've always kept a logbook, more or less, of people that were interested in getting involved in the island. Why don't we pull these books out wherever they are and see if these people are still interested in volunteering and getting involved in the island?
I would assume that they are upstairs in that rec center.
Why are we wasting our time otherwise for people to fill this thing out and we don't do nothing with them? What was the point?
True.
I mean, there may be a... just like the old files that Joe came across and had taken care of, there could possibly be hundreds of people in there that would really like to get involved in it. And they also might have connections that we need.
And that's easy enough to type names and addresses and phone numbers into Word and just save as a document, and it's in a computer.
Sure. Yep.
I mean, with computers, you don't waste any paper. Just create a Word document, save it to a folder. Interested volunteers.
Well, Don, you have pictures that you've taken, right? That are on your slideshow?
On this, yeah.
If we made a new one of these with the same information except for changing this on the back, we could probably put a few of those pictures in there?
Yeah.
Alright, because I'm looking on Microsoft Publisher, I have tons of templates here.
Yes.
That we could use to customize our.
The only thing that you gotta get permission. Was that done by, again, Mike Stricker? You would have to have his permission to use that content whenever, in a reprint.
Yeah.
It's okay the way it is, but if you're gonna add, hell, my suggestion is make up a schedule for dates and times, and we'll get commitments. And sure to die if you have to honor your commitment. If you put down on paper, you're gonna be there. Sure to something physically or seriously happening, you gotta honor your time, or don't just say you can't do it. And then you know ahead of time. Yes or no question? Yes, I can, this is the time. No, I can't.
Actually, you know what, we couldn't even just place the label over this and reuse it because, like on this page, it says, according to the current board president, Joseph C. Abate. So, that, yeah, we would definitely have to redo it. If somebody's willing to work with me.
I can work with you.
Willing retyping it?
I can work with you to make it less specific than that.
Okay.
If we can just make the whole thing less specific.
Now, you can take information out of it as long as you don't copy it word for word, it's not plagiarism.
Yeah.
Or we could also get.
I mean, I kind of.
Get Mike's permission, yeah. I mean, if somebody knows Mike.
You have the ability to copy it word for word as long as you state at the bottom of the page that you did copy it word for word. I mean, that's, I put together a portfolio for Burlington Island, the Midfield Mansion, Burlington City, Burlington First, but I always leave reference at the bottom to state that these facts came from.
So I could just, reference Time and Tide's brief history of the Board of Island Managers. Okay. Alright, well.
I would still just play it safe and make sure he's okay with it.
I would, he had a contact.
Somebody knows him, Scott.
I know Mike, right? I know, Mike's been rather ill for a long time.
Well, you have my email, send me a few pictures that you think would be really good, maybe something that I could make long for the front.
Did I give you the disc?
No, I don't have this.
You don't have the disc?
No.
I'm intrigued in this.
Alright, yeah.
Any other old business? Do you manage or have any new business?
Yes. There was an inquiry from a gentleman, he makes wood instruments. He's inquiring about the Columbia trees. He works with one sawmill and there is been a communication verbally about another sawmill about the downed trees on the island for salvage. And the board can make some change.
Yeah, because I went on a bunch of websites trying to find buyers.
Yeah, but this was going through personal friends and a family member. I'll find it to you later. Yeah, he makes woodblown instruments. This is going through a friend, and I have a relative that they mentioned. Because he's been by on the river, seen all the blowdowns. Because you have maple, oak, white oak, red oak, all blown down on the Mangers side of the property. What's not usable and sellable, we got 10, 12 quarts of firewood.
Can he get it off of there?
Yes. And there's a sawmill, two sawmills in it. Sawmill's interesting.
Okay.
We're not going to pursue this.
And they can get it off.
Yeah, that's what we're going to be, I need permission to start working this detail out.
Some money.
Yes.
So.
And the permission from the board to follow up on this.
Can you find out how, what a, can.
I'll get on how they're doing, their insurance and so forth.
Yeah, and also what kinds of wood we're talking about and how much of it there is, because we have to be able to come up with a fair market value.
Yes. They're only interested, the two sawmills is basically doing a little bit of digging around, and I'm only going to basically say it's blowdowns only.
Okay.
You're not touching a live tree. That is sustainable and green to a certain point.
Unless they're Catalonians and they're willing to pay big money.
Yeah.
I would turn down an offer in the tens of thousands, they could cut every last one of them. Because they grow right back, the Catalonia, they're actually a weed.
It's a weed tree.
Yeah. And they grow quick. They go from seed to harvest in 6 years.
I understand that, but there's not the demand for that that there was.
I know, I've been on the website.
But there's always small interest.
You can't assume we're gonna make as much money on them.
We can make a couple hundred bucks, it's better than zero.
Yeah, you're not.
The reason there was not as much interest was due to the economy. A friend of mine, her father owns a veneer business over on the West Coast, and now that the economy is slowly creeping back, that demand is slowly creeping back because the Polonia trees are more used for special projects, not like furniture and things like that. They're used for.
They're not sturdy.
I talk to her all the time. I mean, I could ask her to check again and see what prices are right now and what kind of projects are going on.
We should actually do it by motion. That way, nobody can say.
I move that we authorize Hal to do the research and talk to these people. Hal, can you also do research on what this kind of thing would be, you know, what kind of this kind of thing brings?
Yes.
You know, blow down trees and
yes.
things like that, and pulling you right now. And, okay. Well, I move that we authorize Hal to do this research.
I second the motion.
The motion has been made and seconded to authorize Manager James to do research and bring a proposal back to the board for blow downs in Catalonia off of Burlington Island. On the question. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. Official, any other?
Still on hold, any other old business?
Wrong now.
Wrong now, I'm sorry.
I just want to make a statement in there. I live out in Columbus Park, and behind my house is actually a woods. And we grew up there and everything. And the city used to issue, actually, a $5 or $10 permit to people that lived in the city that if you wanted to harvest trees that were city property, theoretically, then they would give you this permit. And stated on the permit, I specifically remember, it had to be down or damaged trees. That's what it always said right there. And that's what we always made sure that we clear up. And, you know, virtually every store, you always had some. And it was, you know, there was no reason to go. Now, the other thing that could possibly be is if we had somebody that really knew something about the palimonium trees or anything like that, it could be questionable. The question could be, they could be fit, even though they're live trees, there's nothing wrong with them. It's possible that they could come and address how many do they have. There must be hundreds of them.
Yeah, I mean, they never took every one.
No. And we originally had cut a trail up to there, but we kind of gave up when we got up in there because there were so many of them.
You know, I have property that's pine lands protected, and I'm going to enter into the forestry program.
Right.
And when you do that, they actually want you to take out a certain amount of trees per year to stay in the program. And they give you, like, distance in feet.
Well, how
they don't want any gums cut. No gum trees, but everything
That you can go through the state, basically, and get Christmas trees on the island.
Yeah.
You know, it's more of that kind of thing. And that would be a future harvest.
Any other new business?
Can I take a move?
Yeah. Any other new business?
Yeah, I have one comment I want to make here. I passed around to all the board members a excellent picture of the McNeil Mansion in 1967, if anybody ever wondered what the heck it looked like, and why we would love to try to save it.
It was
actually a picture of it, and this was supplied to us by Judy Gaunt. And also, I gave to Nick a stack of maps, which basically I acquired from Greg Curtin. And what's nice about the stack is it states a few two things about the island. It tells you where every telephone pole is, it tells you where every electric wire is, it tells you where every wellhead is and their number, and it basically states the fact over on the Bristol side of the island, where the little hump is, states the fact that Burlington City has riparian rights to that property. It was granted to the city.
And that was where they closed off the gravel pit where the lake is now?
Yes.
That's how it formed. And what I'm going to do, Don, is I'm going to make copies of these so that everybody has. Do you have your own copy?
I have the original. The only reason I did it that way is because when I sat down to get it done, the guy actually gave me a good-sized map. The problem was the print shop couldn't print it clear enough.
Because it was too big?
Because it was too big, but when I took it and I stuck it in my little printer that I had, and I just kept moving it around, you know.
Oh, is that how you got these?
Yeah, that's how I did that. Just by moving it around, it just came up so much clearer, you know.
So if we put it all together, it'll be one big...
Yes, if you unstable it, just slide all the pieces together in Scotch tape, you got an entire map of the whole island. And like I say, it shows quite a few interesting things in there. It even shows the water pipes and the piping of all the wells. And it even states the fact that there's a 20-inch pipe going from the new waterworks plant over to the island, tied into the T that's over on the island, but it says it's 20 feet above the water, which I don't think that was ever put in.
Right. Any other new business? I entertain a motion for a break before we go to closed session. Matters will be done for that.
Motion for 10-minute break.